Hey guys, welcome to another episode of Your Review Channel. So if you're shooting photos for eBay or any type of online platform, you really should know the right setup. If you're having some issues, you have to convert certain files that the iPhone shoots in, you have to change them. So you have to change the configuration in your phone so you don't have to keep converting them. It saves you a ton of time. So I'm going to show you how to do that. I'm going to give you some quick examples on my eBay store. You can see how the photos come out. So we're going to shoot everything. We're going to change the settings in your phone. So let's go to your phone and let's go under settings. Let's click on settings here. And you want to scroll down, you want to see a thing that says camera. So click on the camera icon. On the top of that, you'll see it says formats. So click on formats. So what we have here is we have two different configurations, high efficiency and most compatible. So what does that mean? So high efficiency basically means it takes the information and basically compresses it and uses it a certain format for the best for the phone, which is called the HEIF/HEVC format, okay? But that's not compatible with eBay whatsoever. So you really have to shoot this in JPEG. So to change your phone to shoot everything in JPEG, that way you can download everything actually on your iCloud. So when you're taking photos with your phone, it actually connects through your iCloud account and everything gets dumped right on your iCloud account. So what you want to do is just hit most compatible. So that'll change that to JPEG. So just remember, high efficiency is the HEIF and then the most compatible, which means JPEG. So it's fairly easy to do that, right? So let's go back here. So let's get done with that. Now let's go to your camera. So let's open up the camera itself, okay? So what you can see here, here's a live image of my desktop. This is a mouse. Let's say I want to take a picture of this mouse, right? You really don't want to use this. I'm not sure if there's a way to make it, you know, permanent, but what you want to do is you want to change that layout. So you click on the top arrow on top here. So see that arrow moving up and down on the top of the screen? You just tap on that and it opens up a box. And you want to click on that box and you want to just tap on the 4x3, and then you want to tap on square. So square is exactly the format that most platforms use for a nice, clean, edge-to-edge, top-to-bottom image. You don't have to crop it. You don't have to edit it. You don't have to convert it. You don't have to do anything. You just take a photo and boom. Whatever you take on your phone gets actually transferred right to your iCloud. And take your iCloud image and work that day. And then when you're done, you can just delete everything. Or if you want to save it into a folder or leave it on your iCloud account, it's totally up to you. So let's take a look at my iCloud account. And you can see here is my iCloud account here. And here is the live feed basically, right? So let's take a photo. I'm gonna take a photo of that mouse and you're gonna see that populate right into the thing. So let's take a photo of the mouse and let's take a photo of that mouse just like I did there. Let's go back to my iCloud account and you're gonna see within a few seconds or maybe 30 seconds, it's gonna just stop, boom, populating it with today's date. And there you go. So it did populate. Takes some time. You take a bunch of photos, do what you have to do. Nice square photo. You can see this photo is really, really square. So here's an example. So I did a VCR and here is an example of that VCR. So you can see here, this is edge to edge, perfect square. You can see that. And in the listing, so when people search that, it fills the whole box. It's a super clean look. You don't have to edit it. My white balance is beautiful, especially the new phones. This is an iPhone 10, but the 12 is fantastic, I understand. So this is an easy way of doing it. This is the way to transfer it to JPEG. Use your iCloud account, download it, and just get rid of that $1,000 camera. You don't need it. This is the simplest way. Easy, easy, easy. The camera just can white balance everything beautifully. You don't have to worry about exposure. You don't have to worry about anything. This is the easiest and simplest way, and you can see everything is super, super clean and super edge to edge clean. You can just see that. Look at that. That's beautiful. So people look around, they can see all your images, super sharp, super clean, and look at that. I mean, the detail is fantastic. It's square, it's easy to read. Shoot it on your phone, it uploads it automatically to your iCloud account, just like you see here, like I shot the mouse, and there it is. See, now if you want to take that and put it on your desktop, all you have to do is click on that, click on the down button, so this downloads that image. Okay, it's gonna download it as a JPEG, because we set up the phone just as a JPEG, and there it is. And when you're done with it, you just drag and drop it on your desktop, and there it is right there. Let's double click on that, and you can see it. It should open up the file. It makes you a perfect, beautiful, square photo, as you can see here. And there it is. Okay, guys, so I just want to make a quick tutorial on how to do that. Any questions or any comments, leave down below. Just a quick tutorial. Basically, it's just, I've been using my $1,000 camera, and everybody says use the phone, and I'm finally saying, you know what, I'm going to use the phone. It's easy. Your phone's with you all the time. Your iCloud is with you all the time. You don't need that expensive camera. It's point and shoot. It's square. It's done. It's good. Okay, guys, I appreciate your time as always. Please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe if you're enjoying my content. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button and also that notification bell if you want to see more tutorials of all types of things that I do on the review channel. So we do everything from soup to nuts, some tech to fun stuff, to cooking, you name it, we do it. All right, I appreciate it as always, and I'll see you at the next review.